Good evening, I'm Ron Cruz. President Noroye's critics, led by ZTE whistleblower Joey De Venecia, are determined to file an impeachment complaint against her. They say there is a need to file a case now to stop alleged moves to extend the president's term. Ron Gagalak reports.
After failing to file an impeachment case against President Arroyo Saturday, Joey De Venecia III says they are all set to go back to the House of Representatives early Monday morning to file their 97-page complaint. Their case against the president, massive graft and corruption and betrayal of public trust. Among the issues incorporated in the complaint are the alleged anomalies in the multi-million dollar contracts brokered by the administration, such as the ZTE-NBN deal, the ZTE Diwalwal Mining Project, and North Rail. Also included are the Fertilizer Fund scam, the Hello Garci scandal, human rights violations like the disappearance of Jonas Burgos, and the alleged bribery of members of Congress.
Sana walang maging problema sa sulutan o unahan, kasi hindi naman parang maganda tignan naman yung may papasok doon na mag-uunahan na kami sa Secretary General's office. At saka sa tingin ko, mas mabuti na kung umabot to at i-refer sa Justice Committee, we let the impeachment stand on its own merits.
While others may think that an impeachment case at this point is untimely, since the country is already looking forward to the nearing 2010 presidential elections, De Venecia says his complaint is not only aimed at proving the indiscretions committed by the president, but is also meant on stopping Mrs. Arroyo from instituting charter change. And the time to do it, he says, is now.
Na yung charter change ay mukhang talagang bumibilis ang patakbo ng charter change. At maaabot na yata nila yung 190 members of Congress. Kinakatakutan ko po doon is that yung chacha ay pwedeng gamitin ni Presidente, o palagay ko gagamitin ni Presidente yon, para extend niya ang term niya sa beyond 2010.
President Arroyo has time and again said she has no plans of staying on after 2010, adding there is no room for term extensions in the event the Constitution is amended. The Institute for Political Reform believes that the next 3 months will be crucial not only for the president but for the entire political arena. Should the Justice Committee decide to tackle the impeachment complaint, Ramon Casiple says lawmakers who are thinking of re-election in 2010 may change their alliances.
Papasok na tayo sa eleksyon eh. At pag ganyan ang panahon, all bets are off tawag yan. Di mo na alam kung saan mga loyalties ng mga specific congressmen. Kanya-kanyang basahan na yan eh.
This, Casiple says, will definitely affect how each congressman will vote on the impeachment complaint and how they respond if Malacanang decides to push through with its charter change initiative. Ron Gagalak, ABS-CBN News.
Malacanang says the planned impeachment complaint against President Arroyo is clearly politically motivated. Press Secretary Jesus Dureza calls the case the launch of the 2010 senatorial candidates of the complainants, namely lawyer Harry Roque and Senate ZTE witness Joey De Venecia. Vice President Noli De Castro also says the impeachment bid will only distract lawmakers from passing much-needed legislation.
Mga congressman, mga senador, busy na rin sa pamumuliti nga, sa pangangampanya. So kung mag-impeachment na tayo, ano magagawa pa? Wala na, mag-aaksaya tayo ng panahon at pera ng bayan. Pero siyempre, karapatan nila yon. Kung meron silang ebidensya, ituloy nila para sa ganon ay mapatunayan talaga.
Some members of the business community say now is the time or is not the time to pursue President Arroyo's impeachment. Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry Chairman Emeritus Donald D. believes the attempt to impeach President Arroyo would only derail the government's efforts to minimize the impact of the U.S. credit crunch. D. says the country should be focused on measures for overseas Filipino workers who may be affected by the downsizing or closure of companies abroad.
And this is not the time for us now to confuse the issue and therefore create a backlash on our effort to try to overcome this financial meltdown that has been unfortunately brought to our shores. Now we just want to focus on getting our acts together, making sure that we overcome this financial meltdown that we are all facing. And I think the Filipino people should not allow people like Joey De Venecia, with very little or no credibility at all, to start messing us up again.
The International Monetary Fund is giving its full support to a plan announced by the Group of Seven industrialized